Hello and welcome to Secret Agent Agency. My name is Kevin, and joining me, I have Andrew. Are you out there?
Hi there.
And back from the mean streets of Kabuki-cho, in person, we have Jihun.
Hi, and I'm still getting used to Pacific Standard Time. Oh, so forgive me if I fall asleep.
And as I alluded to, you are fresh back from Japan. And I want to throw it to you, Jihun. You got any cool stories? Anything cool happened to you there? Anything you want to talk about?
It snowed.
Oh. It snowed in Japan.
Yes. Actually, so I got on Shinkansen, the bullet train, and Tokyo is warm, but on my way to Kyoto is, I guess, colder than Tokyo. Well, I'm getting the name mixed up. Confused. On my way to Kyoto, I was on Shinkansen, and I guess Kyoto region is colder than Tokyo, which kind of makes sense, Tokyo being the downtown, the capital. So on my way down to Kyoto from Shinkansen, I missed my chance to see Mount Fuji because I was on the I was sitting on the wrong side of the Shinkansen, but I also noticed that it was snowing. I was kind of freaking out for a moment because the area that I was passing was covered in snow, so I was kind of worried how the trip going to end up. But luckily, the actual city itself wasn't that much covered compared to the random farming area, which I just uploaded a picture to our Discord chat.
See that?
That's a rather white photo.
Yes. And I'm not talking about skin, of course.
Oh, were you on a bullet train?
Yeah.
How were those?
So it's super confusing. The receptionist or Clark, they're very nice. They're thankfully they're very patient with us. They actually have a translator machine. They just speak into it and then the machine translate right on the spot. However, it was not very accurate, so we had to like try to find the right word so we can understand each other. But yeah, she was nice, patient enough to help us out. So technically you can get on without reservation, but it is preferred that you reserve the seat to not only you guarantee a preferred seat, but also see this guarantees, because I on the last day I kind of got on, maybe I'm not sure if it is Shinkansen, but I got on the train and I realized I got into the reserved seat section of the train. So I had to actually pay on the way, which I was fine with. It's I made a mistake and it was solved by just paying money. Nothing biggie, I'm sure some people would freak out like, I refuse to pay or something like this. Some people can be like this. So. But yeah. And another thing is like, if you Google like the tip on going to Japan, I'm sure some people say like, buy a JR pass, which is like, it's only for the tourist, and then you get access to all the trains. But what they don't tell you is that that is only covered for the very specific line, because if you actually look up more details, JR pass covers a JR line, which is the JR company line. But there are other train companies, some train lines are owned and operated by a different company, so you cannot use the pass if you were going to very specific location. So I had to get the
pilot cards.
Yes, I actually had to get the what they call IC card, which also has its own story for that. Because what it is, so there's actually variety, like, once you get a, or arrive at the Tokyo airport, they're going to give you an option of buying either IC card, different company. One is called Passmo, and one is called Suica. Now, you may be wondering, what's the difference? The difference doesn't show up. Well, you won't realize what the difference is, or the difference is not that obvious to you until you actually go to the specific location, because some train station will straight up say, we only accept Passmo, no Suica IC card. Like, holy crap. And then when you look up some guide on these IC cards, they say like, oh yeah, just at the end of the trip, go back, go to the station, train station kiosk or the information desk and ask them for a refund. It doesn't work all the way because the PASMO card I got is actually is a Tokyo exclusive. Because I got because my return trip was from the Kansai International Airport, which is located near Osaka. So when I tried to get the money out of my IC card, they said, "Oh no, we can't do that." Oh, how come? Oh, because that card is a Tokyo brand. We have a different brand. So I had some money in there. Luckily, I spent the money to buy something within the airport, so no big deal. But yeah, so that's something you have to look out for if you go to Japan and decide to go all the region.
I'm raising my hand. I have a question.
And a can of sardines on those trains.
Yeah. Oh my god. So what's up? What's up, Kevin? What's your question?
Which bullet train had the cutest anime girl mascot?
Sadly, I did not see the one with the mascot on.
Is anybody like nibbling on toast as they're making their way into the train?
No, nobody had that. What's it? They didn't have the bread in their mouth kind of thing going on.
As they were running uphill late for school.
Yeah. It was really packed. And you know what I noticed is that like, so when I arrived in Japan, it was very late night, around like 7 p.m., 8 p.m. or 9 p.m., somewhere between 8 to 9 p.m.-ish, and I had to get on the train to get to my hotel. And I tell you, as somebody who's riding subway train in the San Francisco, it is universal that everybody who's riding the train at late night are fucking depressed as hell.
Yeah.
That is universal, no matter where you are.
No smiles on their faces?
No. I mean, I guess I was the one who's smiling because seeing all the cute girls in the train.
So, for the past 2 weeks, you have just been killing it in our food channel in Discord. Like almost every day you've been posting some photogenic as fuck food. I just wanted what's some of your favorite food based experiences? Did you have a good time at a restaurant? Did you visit any maid cafes? A cat cafe?
I wanted to, but I missed my chance. That's why I kinda wanna go to the second day, but maybe this time more relaxed, because this time I was kind of like, that's one thing I don't like about the going you know, visiting for tourists, is that sometimes depending on how you plan, the times is very tight, so you have to try to it's like sometimes you're too stressed out because you're trying to enjoy a lot, you know, when you're traveling. Yeah.
So you feel obligated to get the most of it.
Exactly. So I wasn't stressed out that much, but yeah, I was trying. Me and my other buddy, the people that I travel with, we were trying to do much as possible. But you know, we just ended up spending too much time in a certain location and had to decided not to visit on some other location. So Akihabara, at least I managed to get there, and then. Back to the food question, yes. So I did have an interesting experience regarding ramen. So there was you could say it's a bad, but at the same time, it's experience is experience. I think it's the valuable experience. So so there was a one ramen restaurant that my buddy found on the Google. It was in Yokohama, and it was it had a good review. And when we got there, there were lines. So we thought it was a good, bad choice. So it was a local's favorite, but because it's greasy as fuck. Like, okay, so because I'm sure you know the basic of ramen cooking or getting the ramen broth is that you're cooking with the pork inside and getting the...
Yeah, you got like pork bones and you're just getting all that gravy and marrow out of there.
Yeah, so, but normally for us, if we were to do that, we would try to get the, like, those fat out or something, right? Like, some people would actually freeze or cool down the soup so the fat solidifies, so you take it out. They don't any of this. Yeah, but...
They just leave it in.
Yeah. I am not kidding when I say this. When I took the first bite, I almost threw up because it was so greasy and fat.
Wow.
Yeah. And I thought like they were kind of exaggerating, because I did hear some people saying like, you know, original Japanese ramen can be greasy. I thought they were exaggerating, but no, they were not exaggerating. If anything, they were right on the spot, or they didn't like exaggerate enough.
Yeah. Yeah.
I almost like after the first bite, I felt like throwing up. Like I was like one bite, like holy fuck. So I had to grab the water right away because it was that greasy and full of fat.
Ooh.
So lesson learned, just because it's a local's favorite doesn't mean it's the best one in the world. So I did go to a different ramen restaurant. So ever since that, I was kind of cautious of a ramen restaurant when I look it up. I have to double check if it's looking greasy or like if the soup looks like it's nothing but fat and grease. That's a one experience. Like I said, it could be considered a bad experience, but ultimately it is an interesting experience, so I can't complain too much about it.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about nerdy stuff. You said you went to Akihabara, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You see anything cool there? Did you go in any game stores?
I tried to find it. Surprisingly, I could not find it. Only store I could find was a bunch of a figurine store. And I did try to find a game store, but some of the quote-unquote game store I found was just some of the latest one. I could not find the like antique.
Used games.
No, I could not find it. Like I said, like we had a limited time, so honestly, if I have a chance to go there one more time, I think I'm just going to spend the whole day on Akihabara alone, just to look around the shelves and all that. And maybe actually enjoy the meat.
At places for just a few hours at a time?
To a certain degree, yeah.
Damn, that's like a mad dash.
Like me and my buddies, we made a list, like, okay, we should go there. Like, yeah, I was like, even then, I was like, I'm greedy, but I know this is not possible. I knew that we had to cut off some of the places we planned to go.
Right.
So, we actually wanted to visit Shinjuku and Harajuku, but we ended up not spending too much time over there. We just like quick glance and went to the different destination. So yeah. And then I kind of wanted to try Maid Cafe too, but like I said, there was not enough time. But there was definitely a bunch of girls on the street handing out like vouchers or pamphlet for their cafe. I guess you could say, it's almost like the, what do you call those guys at the pizza board signing?
Oh, like the people spinning the board or whatever? Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, but, you know, granted, they were not spinning boards or anything like that, but, you know, they
hand out, like, tissue packets and stuff.
Yeah, and they had a pamphlet, I didn't know what they're saying because it's all written in Japanese. But, yeah, all the girls, they're, like, they're about, I don't know what the exact distance, but like I want to say this is 1 to about 20, like 12 feet, somewhere between 12 feet to 24 feet apart. But and they're lined up like they're trying to like then they dress up with their own Maid Cafe version of Maid costume, and they're handing out, you know, trying to advertise their cafe. And I think the reason why they didn't approach me was because I was with my friends, so because I was kind of observing them, but yeah, I noticed that they only hand out their pamphlet to the
single men.
Correct.
Yeah.
I thought you guys were a couple or something.
No, it was because it was two guys and one girl. So, I don't think they just bothered with the group overall, or maybe it was obvious maybe it was obvious that I was not a local, as in like not Japanese, so they didn't want to, there's a possibility they didn't want to deal with a non-Japanese person.
Yeah, Akihabara just sounds nuts. Like, there's no other place like it in the world, I don't think.
Uh-huh.
Everything I hear about it is just like, wow, this is a completely unique place.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, like I said, like, if you want to feel like going there, let me know, but it has to be next year. Mm. Oh, there's one thing I forgot to mention. So we realized way later, about one of our day in our during our stay over there, one of the day was Japanese holiday.
Hmm.
So some of the shops were closed on that day, unfortunately.
Okay.
So that's the one thing I have to that I feel like that's something we have to, if you were to go to, if you plan on going to Japan, that's something you have to
be aware of their local holidays.
Yeah, one thing for sure, I know this is the golden rule, no pun intended, but look out for the golden week. Yeah. That is a one week that you do not want to go there, period.
Just everything's closed.
Well, no, it's the other way around. It's everything's open.
Everything's packed.
Yeah, because that's the week that is a pretty much like international spring break of all Japanese school.
Okay, yeah.
So all the school kids are not in their school and they're trying to hang out as much as possible. So it'll be super packed and oh my god. I can't even imagine like how long the line would be if you were to try to get anywhere.
Yeah, it makes sense. So I wanted to know if you went to visit any like scenic locales. Like one thing that is on my list when I go to Japan is I really want to visit Nara and maybe for like an afternoon go to one of the parks where they have deer with like the sanded down antlers and you can like feed them and pet them and stuff.
Yeah, I didn't get a chance. I forgot where that was located. If it's close, located closer to Tokyo or Osaka. Although, what I did visit was... I can't find this. Motherfucking...
Super Nintendo World.
Ooh.
You went through a warp pipe. Oh my god. That's amazing.
Looks like a level out of Super out of 3D Land.
Yeah.
Also, in that same Universal Studio Japan, there was a Monster Hunter VR experience.
Oh.
So they put you on this VR pack, and then you put the goggle. And then you promise to, well, there's a limitation, but yeah, you play the Monster Hunter game. That's why I posted this picture, but there was no reaction from any of you, unfortunately.
I'm sorry, I've had a rough couple weeks.
I don't post. I only post memes.
Hmm.
It is Monster Hunter. Cat.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not sure if the costumes can be actually worn by real cat, though. They kind of look like clip.
Bowser's Castle, nice. That's incredible.
So I found out that... So, two things. So, Universal Japan... Technically, Universal Japan has two rides, but one in the California has only one ride. So, of course, both location has a Mario Kart racing, but the one in Japan has a Yoshi ride, which you can see in that last picture. You see the people riding a Yoshi thing.
Oh, yeah.
It's nothing special because it's for the kids mostly, but also I'm sure you heard the story how, like, if you want to get in that Super Nintendo World, you have to get those bracelets, and you can get a points for doing that. So, thing about that Yoshi ride is that, is it visible in this picture? Oh, no, but there's some kind of button with the colors of egg. So what you have to do is that the Yoshi ride is gonna tell you there's an egg nearby. What color is it? And you have to choose the correct color of the egg, and then you get a points for that, and you'll be added to your bracelet. And then I'm sure if you find a story about it, you get points on your bracelet and you get a prize. I don't know what the prize is, though.
You didn't get the prize?
No, because that fucking bracelet costs like $40 to buy it.
Oh, shit. So they make their bank.
Yeah. They were really doing that.
So we've about reached about 20 minutes of Japan talk, and mm-hmm. I'm sure you have more, but I also want to get into the game, and I think 20 minutes is like a nice even breaking point for us to jump in. But one thing I did want to lead into was, obviously you see it on the screen, we're playing Judgment. We're starting that up tonight. very excited. It is a spin-off game from the Yakuza or Like a Dragon series, in which you play as a detective in Kamurocho, and you actually visited Kamurocho kind of in real life. It's called Kabuki-cho, correct?
That is correct, sir.
Yeah, and I think as we go through the game, if you have any stories about specific places or, you know, any comparisons between real life and the game, I'm very interested to hear them. But I think we're going to jump in. So this is going to be a pretty story-heavy bit, and I'd like to keep discussion during cutscenes to just kind of like quick reactions to things that are happening in the cutscenes. I think that's fair. We're gonna go ahead and go in.
Sega.
Oh, and I'm going to switch our category from just chatting to judgment. All right. So I just want to quickly say I love this title screen. This is stylish.
It's quite nice.
And I think yeah, we're going to do normal difficulty.
I'm gonna be rocking super duper hard this stream.
No, not after last time.
なるほど。
Oh, I did want to quickly remark that we're playing the PlayStation 5 version of the game.
Oh,
okay. Keep those pictures for reference.
いつまで続くんだろうな、この矢上人気はよ。なあ、沙織ちゃん。源田法律事務所です。ええ、矢上は弊社の所属弁護士です。またご指名か。 みんな無罪取れる弁護士がいいんだとさ、八神先生。参っちゃいますよ。あの裁判はまぐれもあったってのに。当たり前だろ。判決の99%が有罪ってんだ。まあ、だからまぐれだろうが無罪ってやつはでけえ。取った弁護士はヒーローよ。
元がごろつき上がりでもだ。ですね。ですねってお前、いい気になってんじゃねえぞ。なってませんけど。そういう態度には見えねえな。あのな、勝てるばっかじゃねえんだ。俺は先輩としてお前に聞いてんのか。ご忠告ありがとうございます。どうしてもということでしたら、
うちの新谷が相手ます。ええ、矢上より経験豊富な弁護士です。聞いたか。確かに。お前のおこぼれが回ってきそうだ。いちいちうるせえな。そんな、本当ですか。まあ、その点新谷なら。ええ。無罪。でも、そんな。無罪は取ったことないですね。めったにないことですから。ご存知ですか、日本の裁判の 有罪率は99.9%。 とんでもない数字ですよね。
大久保新平。はあ、大久保新平って矢神が無罪にした、あの殺人で逮捕されたそうです。いや、だからその事件は俺が。前のとは別なんです。ついさっき大久保が包丁で恋人を刺した後、ガソリンで火を。なわけねえだろ。
こちら矢神。カイトさん、そっちはどう？もうすぐだよ。今ドンキの近くだ。そっちに向かってる。野郎は見えてるか？ああ、見えた。全然気づかれてないな。<笑>尾行の腕上げたね。おうよ。
我ながら自分の才能が怖え。<笑>そりゃ言い過ぎ。しかし面白いもんだよな。探偵が探偵を追ってるなんてよ。ドラマでもなかなか見ねえよな。そんなのいいから慎重に。
こっから俺も
後ろにつく。おい、おっさん、邪魔邪魔。邪魔くすんだよ。おい、なんだてめえこれ。え、何何、死にたいの。バカかこいつ。おい、何やってんだタボ。いやー、チンピラに因縁つけられてつい。
お前が慎重にって言ってたくせに。チンピラって誰のことだ。ああ、カイトさん悪い、後ですぐ追いつく。適当すぎんだろ。なんだそれ、マジなのこいつ。
へえ、オッケー、やる気満々じゃ。<笑>
Achoo! Achoo! Tega! Kumeru! Shoto janege!
So Andrew, if you look at the picture above it, with the Zilla.
Yes.
That's the word that well, Kevin is right now.
Yeah. Oh, I guess I have to actually
it's like equivalent to what we're seeing in the game right now. We're just kind of like standing around watching. Is this combat system pretty similar to the Yakuza games?
Yes.
Okay.
One thing to note, and they'll explain this a bit later, is you have two fighting stances, and they're neatly divided into single target and AoE attacks. So you have like a stance that's good for one-on-one, and a stance that's good for, you know, crowds.
Got it.
Oh, you're on a 19-month streak. Thank you, Jihun. Oh, okay. Let's...
Have you played this game before?
I played it for like an hour or so. Okay, now we're on finish the battle. Oh no.
Beating the shit out of people with a caution cone.
So one thing I really enjoyed so far was like the subversion they did where it's like, okay, this guy is kind of a disgraced lawyer. He's down on his luck. He's probably unemployed, you know, so they show footage of him just like kind of being a bum on the street. But it turns out he's in disguise and he's working, you know. Just think that's cool.
There's just something I do want to share. Not the trip, but about the Japanese culture. So Japan has known for like criminal conviction of 99% or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
That's because they actually pretty much harass you. If they think you're guilty, they harass you.
Mm-hmm.
To the point like even the innocent people are like, okay, I'll say I'll do it, so can you leave me alone? So that's what happened to this Wikipedia page I posted. He was I forgot what CEO he think. I think it was CEO of the Nissan, and the police kept going after him multiple times to the point like he actually had to flee from the country, and that was the only way. So is he innocent or not? That's a question only future will know. But yeah, the way police Japanese police handled it with their suspect, not even a confirmed criminal but the suspect, it's just insane. And yeah, like I'm sure so many people just admitted up doing the things they did not do because of the harassment. So one quick tip, you might want to find a cat while you're in the search mode for extra bonus.
Oh shucks, okay,
you might hear the cat meowing. That's because you have to find a cat.
Yeah. Okay, so we're in first person view. We observe more closely by holding R2, and then we press X to examine. So the guy's got a mole above his left eyebrow. He's wearing a collared jacket. But first, A cat.
Cat is on the up. Like, he's on the. You have to go look up, and I think cat is on like on top of the board, signboard or something.
Like improbable.
Oh, by the way, you can use your left stick to move around.
That is not true here.
Oh.
At least for this one in particular, you can't.
Okay.
Yeah, I am a turret. Kitty cat.
How long to beat for completionist? This game exceeds 100 hours.
Oh, God, no.
No, it doesn't.
No, I'm saying, like, completing this kind of game, Yakuza game, it's almost impossible sometimes because you have to win the Mahjong.
Oh, yeah, 100% completion isn't going to happen. We are blitzing through the story mode. I'm going to abandon finding the cat.
Yeah, do you actually hear a cat meowing at all?
No.
Okay, then he's not here.
Ayashii na.
Chopa cat guide, Jihun.
Okay, it's not here. I just found it. It's not here. Find the guy first.
Okay, we're tailing. This is pretty straightforward. Guys, we have to maintain a certain distance from our target, but also keep him on screen, kind of. And yep. He'll occasionally check behind him, so we have to hide behind stuff.
Yep.
You gotta avoid filling up his spookometer.
Yeah.
While Kevin is busy doing that, Andrew, on the Discord chat, on the picture I uploaded, do you see the one picture with the Gigo? G-I-G-O? Is it the one with the Gigos? So if you enlarge the picture, do you see the girls?
Let's see here.
Do you see the girls, like, just standing?
Yeah.
Those are the maids, cafe employee.
Okay. Yeah,
yeah, so that's them, like, handing out the pamphlet to advertise their cafe.
Interesting.
Yeah. And I did find that somebody wearing a skinky-ass pants, like, almost straight up, like, showing her butts. And I felt like, oh my gosh, she must be a hoe or something, and then...
And did you see anybody obviously filming a TikTok or something, like just dancing in public?
Yes. Not at the location, but yes. Japan overall, yes. I didn't know this. So I went to this place called Umeda Sky Tower, I think. Let me see. Let me find a picture of the tower and then what's in there. So I'm only sending the sum of the pictures I took on that hour. But
Ooh.
So if you see from the first one, you see how that there's a round thing, and then there's a two, some, like two long border coming out of it. That's escalator, and that is the only. So after you get off the elevator, that's the only way to get to the higher level. Of the tower, and then yeah, there's another picture at the that shows the escalator only.
Part of
it. Yeah.
That's wild.
I don't know if I can upload a video because, like, based on the size, I might not be able to. But one thing I do want to point out, like, yeah, so is it in this picture by chance? No, but some girls. So there's a part of this building where, like, it has a like named a building or something like that, right? Umeda building or Welcome to the Sky Tree or something like that. I saw some girls like bringing out their like acrylic anime stand, and they put them on that name board. And then they just take a picture with it. I thought that was kind of cringe, but adorable at the same time. Let's see if I can upload this video. Hopefully it's not too big. Ah, shit.
You get scored on this stuff?
No,
kind of.
Okay.
The hell?
Ah, shit, my Discord crashed. So there's actually ability. Oh shit!
Oh my god!
This is super dumb. It's like you're losing them, but also like, homeboy's like right here.
So there's ability you can purchase, like where you, if you destroy it properly. It doesn't cause any. It doesn't raise alarm or something like that. There's an ability you can buy.
This is dumb. Okay. Okay. Got my eye on him.
Oh, I kind of like reset it. Champion guy, no one you got.
Champion guy, ga. Asoko wa irikunderu do.
So this bombed out building with the pillars here, by the way, is rather significant in the Yakuza series. And it's nice to see it here too.
Kaito-san, sakimawarishite,
stanbattoite. Wakatta. Makasetoke.
Harikiri sugite mata koasane. Are kekkou sunda kara sa.
Ii kara. Omae wa tantei miushinau na yo.
So I was trying to upload a video, but I think it's actually due to size problem. I think it's crashing my Discord.
Oh, unfortunately. Your files are too powerful.
Yes. Which I did not think it actually crashed the app. Ah, it's crazy. I was uploading an Evangelion-related picture, but Andrew did not respond, so it was not fun.
The Ava?
Yeah.
Ava Galleon's dead to me.
Oh no!
See? Oh, this is where Cat is, by the way.
Oh, like an AT field.
The AT field cup.
Oh, kitty!
Kaido-san, Tantei wa champion.
And there's a giant statue. And we get the on the hands of Ava. You can, yeah, you can definitely do that.
Get on the pigeon.
Honestly, I don't know what I could have gotten you here, like, since Evangelion is dead to you, so I don't know, there's no Eva toy that I can get you.
Plus he does the rebuilds.
手際がいいな、海藤さん。操縦も安定してる。だいぶ練習した？
今話しかけんな。あんま余裕がねえ。あ？誰かいるぞ。探偵の他にもう一人。
やっぱ待ち合わせだったな。見た顔だ。確かカムロ町で競馬の飲み屋やってる。
飲み屋？ってことはあの探偵、借金も返さねえで博打か？世の中舐めてんな。
それよりわざわざこんなとこで飲み屋に会うってことは、多分金の受け渡しだ。
ん？
つまり今なら取りっぱぐれがない。俺らのミッション何だったっけ？
探偵の借金取り立て。なるほど。踏み込むなら今か。
見てな。人稼ぎしてくるよ。
よし、行ってこい、タホ。死巨人じゃねえぞ。
どうも。いい夜だね、探偵さん。
なんだ。
カムロ町の飲み屋はサービスがいいんだってね。当てれば配当は1割増し、外した馬券の1割は客にバック。ギャンブル好きにはありがたいよな。俺も今度やってみようかな。あれ、もう行っちゃうの？まだ探偵さんから金もらってなかったでしょ。
なんだお前、誰なんだ？
うちの客の、そのまた客が、あんたに金返してほしいってさ。飲み屋から馬券買う前にね。
取り立てのチンピラか。よく俺をつけれたな。
チンピラとはご挨拶だな。俺はあんたと同業者。
探偵ってことか。
うん。あんた逃げ足早いんだって。で、うちに依頼が来たってこと。今持ち合わせがあんのも確認済み。もう逃げらんないよ。さ、おとなしく払うも払いな。
ふん、確かに持ち合わせはある。でもな、返すのは馬でもっと増やしてからだ。それまで待っとけや。
本気で言ってんのか。よくそんなずうずうしいこと。
また今度だ。
何でスモークバーム。
カイトさん、やつが逃げた。
見てたよ。何やってんだお前。
くそ、絶対逃がさない。
Pockets in and shit right here.
Is that a smoke bomb or are you happy to see me?
Who gas?
Who gas? Oh shit. Motherfucker just threw a bike at me. All right.
Kaneru.
Ojo giwa ga warui yo, anta.
Uruzai. Ore ni wa na.俺の返済計画があんだよ。
He said Keikaku. Keikaku means plan. Here we go. Crane and Tiger. Okay, so Crane, that's the blue one, is good against groups, and Tiger, the red one, is good against a single opponent.
Oh, you got two schools of, fighting styles here.
That, see, that grapple challenge was so easy compared to fucking MGR. Playing MGR really turned the volume down on this game.
You're also playing on normal.
I am.
I'm sure a lot of these people are like, fighting pros on hard mode.
They just keep coming after you, even though you cut all their limbs off?
Yes. That was amazing. He killed you after he lost both of his arms, didn't he?
Yeah. He lost both of his arms and then jumped around and drop-kicked me.
Yagami da. Kamurocho no Yagami Tante Jimusho.
No, Andrew, I know this isn't America, this is Japan, but how does this compare to how you do business when you're out in the field?
Not at all.
Just thought I'd ask.
These days I don't even really go out to scene as much anymore.
That's true.
Hang around the line.
いいのか。この金取ってくなら、マジで訴えるぞ。見ろよ。鼻の骨が折れてる。鼻血が出てるだけだよ。だいたい先に手出したのそっちだろ。いいや、お前が先に殴った。訴えたら間違いなく俺の方が。これ、弁護士バッジ。お前、探偵なんじゃ。どうする？
本当に出るとこ出る。でもやっぱ相手が悪いと思うよ。You need to click a button to produce your lawyer's badge.
No. I feel like we just had Phoenix Wright's wet dream.
People shit, man. I still haven't played the sixth one.
So how's your first impression with this game? I know Jihun's played it before, but how you feeling, Andrew?
Looks neat. Wizard is going to be kind of like, is that kind of show you most of the game modes?
Yeah, that felt like kind of a vertical slice, as I call it.
What do you mean by vertical slice?
So kind of a demonstration of all the gameplay systems, all in kind of like one part.
How's this one? Oh, this guy just now, Kyohei Hamura, this guy. So for those who don't know, this guy is actually a replacement of the other guy, because ironically, he was caught in this drop bust.
Yep.
So, which is funny, because the Yakuza game or Judgment game is based, you know, crime and all that kind of stuff, and yet all the castings are clean.
Yeah.
So, when the original the person they based off of got caught on, like, I forgot what kind of drug it was, but he got caught for drug possession, so they replaced him with another one. And this isn't the only one. If you actually look into some of the past Yakuza titles, there were a couple of cast out there who's been replaced with another actors due to their association with the actual crime they committed. Which, yeah. Like I said, is ironic or funny, considering what kind of game this is.
Yeah, I am aware in Japan that like even like possession of weed is like a huge deal over there.
I believe so. Yeah, they're not really open about the uses of weed even. There's the picture of the gate on the picture I uploaded. The picture of the red gate. forgot that there's a anime called the Kill Me Baby. It's a comedy slice of life. One of the lead voice actress, she got caught on the drug charge, so they practically scrapped the whole anime because of that.
That's a bummer.
This is what this video game is showing right now is very inaccurate because I was not approached by the hot girls just like they did it just now. So I was not approached.
It's a shame. Oh, I like that one guy's plague doctor mask he was wearing in the hoodie.
These people parkouring.
Yeah.
Parkour! Need some parkour cops.
Would you like to volunteer? I'm sure you have a lot of cardio working on, right?
Ish.
Just for reference, the Tojo clan of Yakuza is a big player in the story of the Yakuza games.
ただ一人の従業員にして俺の兄貴分海藤さんは元東条会系のヤクザだそして俺は矢上隆之は3年前に法廷を離れた弁護士でもある俺の持つ弁護士バッジにはもう飾り以上の意味はない
SEGA!
The arcade did not exist when I went there, unfortunately.
Yeah, a lot of the Sega centers are shutting down, aren't they?
That's correct.
Yeah. Sucks.
Chapter 1. Do you know how many chapters there are?
You can feel free to look that up.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, it's like you've only played so much. Never mind.
Yeah. This isn't as much as I've played, by the way.
Yeah. また源田先生のとこに行ってみるわ。なんか仕事ないかって。あそこの法律事務所。
Yeah, I'm expecting to get about 40 hours or so out of this game. We're going to primarily be doing the main story and skipping all the side quests. That being said, if Jihun is like one or two that he recommends, I'm happy to do like a couple of them.
菓子折りぐらい買ってけ。ちゃんとカッコつけろ。
You played all of this game, Jihun?
I played Zero, Kiwami 1, 2, and 6, 7. I did not touch. Well, I attempted to play 3, but this because everybody was high for it. But
were
this
they?
Was when I. Yeah, when like. When it first came out, very first. When it came out the very first time for US.
Okay.
I tried to play, but for starters, it didn't click with me, and the fact that. I forgot, and then I tried to play 4, but my god, yeah, the one of the longest intro ever.
Yeah.
So I kind of hold it off on the 3, 4, 5, for sure.
Yeah, so six? I played. Go ahead. You're still going.
Six. I kind of don't recommend it. It's only Yakuza game that I was able to 100% it, but I do not recommend it. There's something about the combat. I think this is when they start implementing the new Dragon engine, which also reused for the Kiwami 2. Or was it Kiwami? I forget. It gets confusing sometimes.
Kiwami 2.
Yes. But I think they didn't get the everything tight, so I don't personally recommend 6. There's something with it feels off, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, it could be just me, because like I said, I'm the guy who still prefer the combat system of Zero and Kiwami. I just like the when the battle starts, I like to have a like different mode, quote unquote. Like it's something like that, like just feel tight. The combat feels tight when it's dead. That's why I don't like the combat from Kiwami 2 and so forth. Something about that it just doesn't feel tight. Like I said, it could be just me, because I know Kevin has a different opinion of that.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Kiwami 2's combat, but I haven't played 6. And this seems like it's kind of splitting the different. Like, it's definitely the Kiwami 2 engine, but it feels like, gameplay-wise, it feels like it's splitting the difference between, like, say, Kiwami 1 and 2. Oh, God.
Oh, we get our DLC. I saw figurines. Oh, there's a lot of cats.
Help!
I wonder if you're getting all the DLC because you bought the PS5 version, because I don't remember getting some of
those.
I guess this is the super edition of the game.
Probably.
He has like the same shit in Persona 5 Royal.
Oh yeah, which
you, like, check just your box.
Yeah. Which I did mention that I think I will play the PC version because it comes with all the DLC. And yeah, those custom DLC as well as the extra Persona DLC looks nice, although, so I do want to try get my hands on them. I did not have access to those on the PS4 version, so
I don't think I have enough room for 5 cats on there.
Oh, there are other shelf that you can put them on, like fridge or something. Yeah, click on the there we go, R1 and L1.
Yo, fuck this plant.
Kevin, I think this is becoming a favorite game of yours with all the cats.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder how much that cost in the original game.
That's a good question. I wonder.
Only cat DLC.
I bet if I get it just right, pixel perfect, I can get 5 cats.
Can we start from the edges?
Ah, well.
Oh, speaking of DLC, so they announced this week Elden Ring finally getting
yes,
DLC. Just one image.
Yeah, supposedly it'll solve the mystery of I forgot the character's name.
Probably.
Yeah.
Probably access it from his cocoon at the end of Moog's boss fight.
Speaking of the event of the week, I don't know how big this is for you. I mean, it depends on your perspective of this thing, but Jack Dorsey, the guy who made Twitter and left the company, is working on a new social media. So I don't know if I should hope for it or... Well, then again, right now I do want everybody to migrate away from Twitter overall, so...
Yeah. People just aren't doing it. Like, what's it going to take?
I mean, you think for real, like, you think, like, ever since the purchase of Twitter, anybody could come up with something half bad, half good of Twitter, and then they could be still be successful. Just like, this, you know, or like, just make a fucking copy of the MySpace and boom, you're successful, you know? But nobody done it. I just don't know why.
No, there are copies of MySpace, but they're not successful. I don't know if there's no marketing or what, but...
You know what? Oh, I think it could be marketing. You know what stupid thing is that, didn't Elon Musk straight up, like, pause, like, block the people from advertising other social media or something like that for time being? I remember that being...
Yes, you can't link to posts on your Facebook, you can't, have Linktree, you can't have, like, any of that stuff. It's really amazing. Like, you have to, like, content creators now have to vaguely, like, hint and gesture towards their content. They can't link to it. And it's like, people start leaving. Like, what's it going to take?
A true competitor to rise up. Knock down all these, other social media environments.
Also, I don't know if the you guys or viewers of this stream heard the news where, like, Elon Musk was freaking out because not many people are looking at his posts compared to other people.
Yeah, so he made it so his posts are the top of your feed, yeah.
I fucking blocked that guy. Somehow it still showed up. Like, are you fucking kidding me?
Yeah.
or actually, no, I didn't block him first time. First time I said, like, because some people that I follow were following him, so I saw the them liking that post, and I was like, okay. I back then when before he purchased the Twitter, I just said, like, please show less of this guy, and then that worked. But now I straight up had to, like, mute the guy or block. So the moment I saw his tweet on my feed, I'm like, fuck no. Get that shit out of my face.
Yeah, my personal rule now is I use Twitter until I see an Elon Musk tweet, which is like 2 minutes tops.
Like I said, just mute or block the guy. It makes your life easier.
Nah, I like it my way better.
Punched him so hard in the chest, blood flew out.
Well, I beat him up too.
Oh, okay.
Think maybe he broke a rib.
Hey, こいつは昔親父が学費の面倒を見て弁護士にしたんだがよ。腕が良すぎて、マジモンの殺人鬼まで無罪にしちまったんだ。マジっすか?すごいっすね。優秀だろ?全く<笑>こんなとこにいちゃもったいねえ。ところがな、その殺人鬼はシャバに出てきた途端 今度は自分の恋人ぶっ殺しちまったんだよ。マジっすか。結局それで死刑よ。そういやあいつもう潰されたか。執行はまだです。早く済ませりゃお前もすっきりするのにな。ああ。まあこれ例の探偵から取り立てた金です。 もううちの取り分引いてあるんで、あとどうぞ。おお、板についてきたじゃねえか。取り立てや。おかげさまで。カイトのやつは元気か。ねえ。なら一つ聞いといてくれや。うちを破門にされたもんがいつまでこの町にいるんだってよ。 お前も親父のお気に入りでいるチャを多めに見ててやる。
松金のおやすん、お元気ですか？
素人が余計な首突っ込むんじゃねえよ。ああ、行くぞ。
Oh yeah, random encounters.
You love
the, the random encounter they handle in this game is very unknown. So for the Andrew who did not get a chance to read that prompt, is that normally this isn't a definite new mechanic in this game, but you have to finish the fighting the random encounter like soon as possible, otherwise the local cop would try to arrest you. And then when that happened, you lose money. And so this is where I got annoyed, is that there's a one particular side quest or something like that that can be only triggered by letting yourself get caught by the cops.
Ooh.
I'm like fuck no.
Arrest
I was so annoyed,
me, daddy.
Basically, so I was like fuck no. I don't know if I was getting arrested or running away from the cops. I don't know which one it is, but yeah, when I found that out, oh my god, I'm done with this game. There's so many design choices. Oh, and the thing, the place, Kevin just passed. It's on the, it's in the one of the picture. It's at one of the big yard, like, it says Tokyo Kabuki-cho Tower. It's that picture, that big area. Yep.
Yo,
that's the word. Kevin just passed.
So, like the kind of player who doesn't go for most wanted in all the Skyrim holds.
Hahaha.
They've introduced so many characters, I don't remember anyone's names.
Yeah, it'll be okay. The important ones will stick out, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, main character is Yagami, his sidekick is Kaito.
Yep.
Okay.
シンタニ先生はどちらに夕方から見てねえの。まあちょうどよかったじゃねえか。顔は合わずに済んで。え?お互い嫌いだろ。お前らどっちも相手をバカだと思ってるからよ。まさかそんな尊敬する兄弟子ですよ。それをバカにするなんて。うちの仕事が欲しければあいつともうまくやれよ。お前もっとお先輩に敬意を払ってたな。あ、源田先生。 ドラえきどうです。先生なら絶対気に入ると思って。あ?あれ?全部言っちゃった?半分なら残ってます。
He's just like, really?
No, Saori-san.
Over the mall, man.
Nai
desu.
Ano, nanka shigoto arimasen ka, Genda-sensei?
Shigoto na.
Any work.
Sosomo, omae, itsu made tantei nanka tsuzuken da? Konna abunakkashii machi de.
平和な町じゃ仕事になりませんよ、探偵は。借金の取り立てが探偵の仕事か?まあ、仕事がないよりはいいかと。そりゃ探偵じゃねえだろう。何でもやだ。もともとそんな感じで始めた家業ですから、俺の場合。
なあ、八神。
はい?
お前もう弁護士に戻る気はねえのか。
ありませんね。
どうしてもかよ。
見てください。俺のこの目。
ん？
こいつは人が善人か悪人か、まるで見分けられないんですよ。そんな奴に弁護士なんて任せちゃダメです。
3年前の件なら、あれはお前のせいじゃねえぞ。あれは、お前が優秀な弁護士だからこそ起きた事故だ。
事故だとしても俺は、あんなの二度とごめんなんですよ。仕事ないですか、先生。暇にしてるとあの日のこと思い出す。
I suspect there's gonna be more to that story later in the name.
だから何でもいいんで、ずっと忙しくしてたいんです。
離婚裁判の証拠集めは、例によってラブを張り込んで、証拠写真を撮影、それから尾行とゴミ漁りだ。やるか。
いいですね。もちろん喜んで。
お手上げだな。後で資料送っとく。次来るときは手土産いらねえぞ。金が余
る。Oh, there was a PlayStation 3 firmware update this week.
了解です。
What? Why?
The most stable console in the world.
Why are they still updating the PS3?
I don't know.
現代法律事務所です。
Stability update.
ええ、います。わかりました。矢上さん、新谷先生から。
ん？
裁判の証拠集めを頼みたいそうです。殺人事件の。
殺しの？
なんだよ。うちにそんな案件あったか。
いえ、私も今初めて聞きました。
もういいだ。
さっきの離婚裁判は忘れていい。新谷を手伝ってやってくれ。殺しの弁護なんざうちも3年ぶりだ。
新谷先生、太平通りのバーにいるそうです。すぐ来てほしいと。
太平通りのバーって。
テンダー。
テンダー。
そうです。バーテンダー。
Your friendly bartender.
Oh yeah, we're gonna have to fight. I want to be in blue stance.
This game have like perfect guarding stuff.
I believe it does. I know the Yakuza games have like a parry, and that's actually, if it exists here, it's probably going to be one of the things I prioritize getting. Quick step cancel is very good, like being able to zip around a bit.
That's how Goblin works in this game.
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of already have a build in mind?
I have not played this before, Andrew.
But I presume it's like got similar characteristics to Yakuza?
Yeah, I would think so too, but still learning together. Yeah, and I think with how we're going to be playing this, we have to be kind of careful with how we spend our points, think about it a bit. So we're definitely going to want to increase our intimacy when having a conversation with our girlfriend.
Yes. That's important.
Yeah.
Level up your social links faster. Well, Jihun was out in Japan.
Yeah, you went to Florida, right?
Weather was nice.
Very cool.
Didn't get to head up the beach, but toward the pool.
Tabo ka. Oku ni Shintani sensei kiteru yo.
Ah, shigoto no hanashi nan da.
Mata kichatta.
あんま飲みすぎんなよ、マリネ。あの人、ターボーの連れなの？仕事相手、今日のクライアント。うちの仕事が欲しけりゃ、もっと早く来い。遅すぎんぞ。急な呼び出しに遅刻もないだろう。妙な先輩風は良してくれ。一杯飲ませてもらいます。俺の金でか？ いや、源田事務所の交際費ってことで。登場会の松金組若頭、羽村恭平。お前はよく知ってるな。今日もさっき会ったよ。羽村の頭が依頼人？ああ、逮捕された。殺人とした言い気でな。マジで？マジだよ。で、 松金組からうちに弁護の依来が来ちまったんだ。まあ、松金の組長は裁判ごとじゃずっと源田先生を頼りにしてきたからな。でも今回はなんであんたが。はあ、源田先生が俺の名刺渡してたらしくてよ。たく、なんで俺がヤクザの弁護なんて。
ご愁傷様。
これから神室署で羽村に接見する。
お前も一緒に来い。俺と違ってヤクザには慣れてんだろ。うん、かもね。接見の前に事件の大筋を共有しておく。まず被害者は関西から。一週間前、神室町のゴミ捨て場で死んでるのが見つかった。おい、その事件って。ああ、死体の目がえぐられてたって例の事件だ。<笑>
警察はハムラをその犯人と見ている。でかい事件だな。今までに目をえぐられたヤクザは3人。同一犯の連続殺人なら相当注目されるはずだったんだがや。ん？初めの2件はハムラにアリバイがあった。で、警察は3件目についてだけハムラを犯人と言ってんだ。
連続殺人じゃないと。Yes, you got thrown into AFK。全部未解決じゃ警察もカッコつかねえ。だから多少強引だろうが今回のだけでも片付ける気なんだろう。どうせ被害者はヤクザだ。And that was through Andrew's speakers, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Oh shit. Oh fuck. We gotta pay attention. Okay. Clever thinking is rewarded. Okay, so we get a SP bonus if we're able to consecutively select the best choices.
Ready? Probably have a good, okay. Good feel for this guy.
Yeah.
I'm resuming this is timed, so I'm not going to really give you any input, really.
Hamura wa jiken no koto nante itten da?
Yatte nai to itter sou da. Keisatsu no iigakari da tomo na.
Jya muzai o shuchou suru tte koto ka?
うん。警察がハムラを逮捕した理由は？理由は2つ。被害者はカムロ町に進出してきた関西ヤクザで、もう何ヶ月も登場会と抗争している。 となると十中八九殺したのは東条会系列のヤクザだ。で、羽村もその一人。
もう一つの理由は？
事件当日、羽村は被害者と口論をしていた。
事件前に被害者と喧嘩してたからってことか。実際に羽村が殺したのか。あんたどう思う？
そんなのわからねえし、どっちでもいい。依頼人が無罪を主張するんなら俺も法廷でそうする。それが弁護士の仕事ってもんだ。
もう十分わかったよ。そろそろ店を出よう。
先に行っててくれ。俺は何本か電話かけてから行く。カムロ署までタクシーで行っていい。
わかった。
So I guess you can exhaust all dialogue, but if you pick the smartest choices, you get more.
Yeah.
Give you more EXP too, didn't it?
Yeah, that's the. Yeah, that's what it was rewarding me with.
Good.
もう行くのか、タボ。珍しく。
Can we look out if there's like any like.Really broken thing we really want, or do we just play it by ear?
We probably just don't have access to it yet.
Okay.
また時間ある時に話そうか。
仕事もらえるなら助かるよ。
ならまた手が空いたら来てくれ。ターボに仕事を頼みたいって。
So that's probably a side quest.
Yeah, so the map's a little busy, but I think we just are going to any taxi. Yeah.
No crazy ones, though.
No.
Ask Jihun if they have Uber in Japan.
I'm sure they have something like it. Also, Japan's just really walkable.
Hamura-san, Genda 法律事務所の新谷です。組の方からご依頼を受けまして。
ああ、頼りにしてるぜ、新谷先生。まあ、俺らも仲良くやりましょうや。うちの親父と源田先生みてえに。
ああ、そうですね。では早速ですが、いろいろ聞かせてください。話の裏取りや調査はこちらの八神が進めます。
そりゃ頼もしいな。
よろしくどうぞ。
逮捕の理由は殺人ということでしたが、そのお心当たりはあるんでしょうか。
ああ、お心当たり、
実際に頭がやったのかってことです。どうなんです？
やってようがなかろうがよ、お前らの仕事は俺をここから出すことだ。違うか？
違いますね。俺はもしあんたがやったって証拠を見つけたら
手を引くのか？
いや、それを検察に渡してあんたをムショに送らせます。
ふざけんな！てめえは殺人鬼だって無罪にしたんだろうが！
おい、八神。
3年前、少なくとも大久保新平は無実の可能性が高かった。だから俺も信じることができた。
でもその後大久保は恋人を刺して火までつけたじゃないか。
ターボ、あん時お前は無罪取るって手柄に目がくらんだんだよ。だから人殺しかもしれねえって男を野放しにした。だろ、正直に言えよ。
疑わしきは罰せずですよ。
なら焼き殺された娘の親にもそう言ってみろ。それができねえから逃げたんだろ、弁護士って仕事からよ。
事件の話に戻
す。Hard on this guy so much. I like he killed the girl.
お前もいいな。
わかったよ。続けてくれ。
失礼しました。では、まず被害者は教令会組員で、名前は久米敏郎、年齢は34。12月4日の早朝6時、ゴミ捨て場に死体があると110番通報がありました。
事件前に頭は被害者と揉めてたそうですね。
ああ、
警察は何か言ってませんでしたか？他にも頭を逮捕するだけの証拠があるとか。
そんなもん俺にわかるわけねえだろ。なあ、新谷先生。
ええ。ただ、警察にどんな証拠があるか、今の時点では弁護士にも開示されません。起訴前は、羽村さんの話だけが我々の頼りでして。
そうかよ。
それじゃあ、八神、お前から羽村さんに聞いておきたいことは。
Bullshit, then I have discovery?
I don't know. So what do you think we ask about first? I'm thinking maybe we ask about his alibi, because that's kind of the part that we have no information on, right?
Yeah.
Because we kind of have an idea about the argument with Kume. We have an idea about the police response. We know who the victim is, so let's ask about the alibi.
Kashira no alibi wa dou nan desu?
Okay, so far so good.
Mazu higaisha no shibou suitei jikoku wa?
Shinya 2 kara 3 ji no aida rashii.
I'm suspecting the order doesn't matter so much as you pick the...
I think the order does matter.
Oh, it does?
I think so.
Kamurocho no sauna goten. Jihun would know more. Asa made zutto na. It seems.
Tada shi sore o urazukeru shouko shougen wa nashi. Desu yo ne?
Well, that is, that's spent the night streaming.
So you koto da. Fuzaketa hanashi da ga yo.
Okay. So I'm thinking we ask about the victim and then ask, I guess, what they argued about.
Yeah.
被害者の身元は確か
久米敏郎34歳。
He pretty much said the police are like tight-lipped, so I just be a repeat of. Didn't tell me shit.
構想中の関西ヤクザが敵地で一人きりってことは。
ああ、もう一人連れがいた。野郎の兄貴分だろうが、名前は知らねえ。
教令会の人間は合わせて二人か。
こっちは俺を入れて松金組が5人いた。
Okay, let's see what they argued about.
I'm grabbing the ice cream bar.
Yeah, I'm gonna be having us take a break after this cutscene. Does that work for you?
その店先で。俺は組の若いもん連れてた。
Cool.
その時に協力会と睨み合いになってよ。ああ、そいつが組って野郎だった。
喧嘩ふっかけたのは頭の方から。
ああ、関西の下っ端にでかい顔されたんじゃメンツが立たねえ。それに俺もまあまあ酒が入ってた。
それは何時頃です？
うん、9時過ぎだ。
久米と睨み合いになった後はそれで終わりですか？
いや、野郎が逃げようとしたのを捕まえてよ、アムールの中に引きずり込んだ。
は？
いや、口論って聞いてましたけど。じゃあ羽村さんは大勢で被害者を拉致した？
ああ、アムールはうちの組でケツ持ちやってる店だ。で、中にいた客は全部返してよ。しばらく組に焼き入れてた。ただ殺しちゃいねえ。その後奴は裏口から叩き出してやった。俺もそのまま店を出た。12時よりは少し前だ。
なるほど。すると被害者はあんたらに無理やり拉致され、朝には目をえぐられてた。俺が警察でも頭を逮捕しますね。
Okay, so we already got our points. I guess we can ask about the police response now.
警察でこの事件担当してるのはなんて刑事です？
カムロショ、組対の黒岩だ。 新谷先生なら知ってんじゃねえか。
ええ、敏腕というより剛腕って評判の刑事です。前にあった凶霊会の殺しも担当してたはずで。
ヤクザをヘとも思ってねえ。気に食わねえデカだ。
OK、
今聞けることは大体聞けた。
わかった、よし。ヤガミ、お前はこの後サウナ御殿に行ってくれ。一応店員に羽村のアリバイを確かめろ。
了解。
もしアリバイが証明できりゃ裁判するまでもね
え。Some time.
明日報告してもらうぞ。こっちから連絡する。
Can't believe we're already getting our hot spring episode. Well, okay, so I'm going to stop this here. This is going to be our episode one. I'm going to take about a 10-minute break on stream and come back and film episode two.
Yep.
So here I go. I click the button and...